This section is called the Kalman filter part 1, and basically the Kalman filter is quite simple. These are the Kalman filter equations, and all you need to do is to apply them in the next self-driving car project that you are building. Good luck. No, I'm kidding. I'm just kidding. Truth is, these equations are very complicated, and this is why, although the Kalman filter is quite important in control theory, very few students, especially in computer science, understand them, and even fewer apply them in their projects. So, what we want to do in this section and in the next one is to explain the Kalman filter step by step as slowly as possible. So, you will be able to utilize the Kalman filter in your next projects. What is so special about the Kalman filter? First, some history.
The Kalman filter was invented in 1960 by Rudolf Kalman. Actually, it was also independently invented 2 years earlier by Peter Schwilling, but the name Kalman became popular.
This is the end of the history part. Now, the Kalman filter is an optimal filter. What does it mean? That given the right assumptions, and we will discuss these assumptions, the Kalman filter produces the best result. Another thing is that the Kalman filter is quite efficient. One of the most beautiful examples of this efficiency was the Apollo navigation computer, which although had only memory of 2K, implemented the Kalman filter to better its navigation in outer space. So, in my experience, I've noticed that students are scared of the Kalman filter because of the matrix notation it demands, which is why we will split it into 3 phases. In this section, we will discuss the mathematical and intuitive basics of the Kalman filter. We will constrain ourselves to 1 dimension only. In the next section, we will expand what we just learned into multiple dimensions. And in the section after that, we will expand the notion of Kalman filter beyond its linearity. We will deal with non-linear scenarios. This is a good opportunity to say that if you have begun the course with this section because you wanted to know how the Kalman filter works, I suggest you go back to the previous section, the histogram filter, and skim through it. It will give you an understanding of many of the things that we are going to do here, including Bayes' theory, etc. Friends, we are about to begin a journey of 3 chapters, and by the end of this journey, I promise you that you will not only understand the Kalman filter, but you will also be able to apply it and write it in Python programming language. Good luck!